Es inútil dejar de quererte. Ya no puedo vivir sin tu amor. No me digas que voy a perderte. No me quieras matar, corazón. Yo que diera por no recordarte. Yo que diera por no ser de ti. Pero el día que te dije te quiero, te di mi cariño y no supe de mí.
So again we're in the edible part. That's obviously an apple tree, French Golden Delicious. Other fruit trees are around. Here we have the black currants. They're still green obviously, but they will be black. Or maybe it's a red currant, this one. They're pretty much the same leaf. Yes, Crucelero Rojo, that will be the red currant, this bush. So there's a kumquat, orange tree in flower. Obviously in Spain there's many oranges, especially in the area of Seville. One thing you can always have, freshly squeezed orange juice in this country. Tastes different to make from concentrate like we have. There's a mandarin tree here. You won't get this growing out in the open in Poland. It will not survive one winter. Here you have a lemon tree, or rather a lime tree. Limon is, citrus limon is the lime tree. This lima is probably some kind of a lemon. This is a pomelo. This is a sweet orange, which is Citrus sinensis, the standard orange that you get. Also known as Sinas apple in Dutch, because it's from sinensis from China. Originally the orange came from just a little pomegranate tree, just beginning its working life, many years to come before it becomes like the one I showed at the beginning. Juglans regia, the walnut, is basically part of the Balkan Peninsula, is where it originally come from, but it's known as the Italian nut in some countries, like in Polish it's called Orzechowski, but it's originally from Balkan Peninsula. It will not grow too far north in Europe because it doesn't like the cold winter. Halfway up Poland it stops. You will find it growing happily in southern Poland, like Wrocław, making a plenty nuts for whole the family. And then when you get to Warsaw, well, you do in the in sheltered corners of Warsaw you will see them, but out in the open they will not survive. The thing about the walnut is it actually produces a massive root system, and people used to plant them when they became fashionable a little bit too close to houses, and in the end they would push the wall up and you would have to, you know, basically get rid of the tree and rebuild the wall to your house. So probably that's why it got the name walnut in English. The ability for the origin of the name walnut relates to Wallachia, the region in the Balkans which also got confused with the Italians, because Romanians basically lived there, and Romanians were confused often by Germans as being a kind of Wallach. It's also the same word which Germanic tribes use for the Welsh. So it's also a possible origin of the term walnut, although I think I like my version better. This is pretty. Not too sure what it is either. I think I walked into these little red berries, into the bay which is for the Spanish plants, because I've noticed that it's not properly signposted, but I've noticed that these plants are all signposted as coming from Iberian Peninsula and from Canary Islands, which also is Spain, I suppose. So, yes, Peninsula Iberica, there's a kind of barberry bush here. So I think I'm in that bed which was in the guidebook about, this is the Balearic Islands, yes, this must be the one, which is dedicated to endangered plants from Spain itself and the Spanish area. So obviously this is a place which needs particular respect. I hope everybody will come, who comes to this garden, will look out this bay. And now I'm not surprised that I didn't know what this is. If it's special from Spain and only grows in Spain. But I did see this in Marbella, I think, one time. Balearica is the Balearics box tree. And this is a funny looking, look how it grows along the ground. This Balearic box tree, not making up a strong upward habit like most box trees do. Pieces of rhododendron here from the area. Oh, somebody is blowing their whistle. I think this is the whistle to say end of play in this garden. But all I really want to see on the way out, and it is on the way out, is the roses. If I tell him this, he might say, I beg your pardon, I never promise you the rose garden, but hopefully he will let me just to quickly get as far as roses are. Well, I have to go by them anyway, so what are they gonna do? Stop me filming, put the hand in front of the lens? So there we go. It's coming around the same way again, because this is so pretty. It's tan bonita. Unless all the plants in this garden, may they not go extinct, especially the endangered ones. Of course, in paradise we will have even more, but I would like to see some of these in Kevin too, you know, all of them turning up there. Positive is the upright habit, sort of like climbing roses. I've still got 9 minutes, so I want to make the best of it. Look at them. And of course, it's quite an early flower, isn't it? Because usually it's in Northern Europe more like June when you're getting them coming up. Many different shapes, even leaf shapes are very different. But these are peonies anyway, are they not? Not even, or are they roses? No, it must be a rose. I'm talking rubbish. Some people say I do a lot of that. But I can't take this rudeness on my channel in the comments. If you're one of the people that leave rude comments in my channel, please don't do this. It really, you know, it's like that bramble bush for me when you're rude, you know? You know, the one Br'er Rabbit got pushed in. He didn't like that. So don't be rude to me. It's like pushing me in that old bramble bush when you do this. And I don't want that, you know. So no rudeness, please. No rude comments at all. I will probably block you and ban you from YouTube like I did to Neon Rabbit Jr., who doesn't exist anymore. Although he keeps coming after me with his phony accounts. So. Oh, isn't this lovely? Looks like a dog rose on a tree form. Very many different kinds of them. Very impressive. I really gave it a good justice, I think, with this film. Although the light was not so good, it's the end of the day. You may be interested to know that it's nearly 9 o'clock. But of course, Spain is on the western side of the European time zone. It includes Poland, of course. In Poland, the sun went down about at least an hour ago. But this is so much further west, and so it's still light. The time zone is the same because we are Europeans and we want to have a single time zone. This is your yew tree, so be careful not to eat those berries if you see them. They are poisonous. More hazelnuts if you can eat. This is Fatsia, is it not? Looks like Fatsia, but it's not got the Fatsia sign, but I'm pretty sure it is Fatsia anyway. There is your usual croton, but it's completely grown in a different habit to the one you'll get in a pot in Northern Europe. Rhododendrons of a small type, these grow massive, of course, in Poland and Britain. Azalea, as they're also known. All you need for them is a very proper soil, is to be acid, full of peat, and then they will grow lovely. I didn't know this plant. Don't know what that is, and I can barely see now, of course. But it may be a kind of rhododendron too, from the leaf, but isn't it unusual? Strange looking. This is a beautiful, more classic azalea color here. Oh, I think I had a feast for my eyes really in this place, but I just want to take advantage of the last minute just to go around here, because I can see a lovely set of really beautiful roses here, and I like just to get the full color of this here. Take a few photographs to finish off with of these.